Today I am going to discuss about two concepts. One is polygenic inheritance and second one is probability. The first one, polygenic inheritance. Polygenic inheritance. Poly means many. Genic means genes. Some characters are controlled by many genes. Such characters are called polygenic characters or quantitative characters. Quantitative characters. Okay. Polygenic characters also called quantitative characters. The opposite words for polygenic is oligogenic and quantitative is qualitative, right? The mode of inheritance of polygenic characters, the mode of inheritance of polygenic characters is known as polygenic inheritance. Polygenic inheritance or quantitative inheritance. Quantitative inheritance. As this process involves several genes or factors, as this process involves several genes or factors, it is also called multiple factor inheritance. It is also called multiple factor inheritance. Therefore, we can say polygenic inheritance is also known as quantitative inheritance, also known as multiple factor inheritance. Right. The term polygenic was first coined by Mather, Mather, in 1941. The term polygenic was first introduced by Mather in 1941. Okay, I repeat, polygenic inheritance. Poly means many, genic means genes. Several characters are controlled by, one character is controlled by several genes. Such characters are called polygenic characters or quantitative characters. And such genes are called polygenes. The mode of inheritance of such characters, that is polygenic characters, is called polygenic inheritance or quantitative inheritance or multiple factor inheritance. The term polygenic was first coined by Mather in 1941. And polygenic inheritance differ from pleiotropy. Let us compare here. If one gene is related to several phenotypes, phenotype 1, phenotype 2, phenotype 3. This is called pleiotropy. This is called pleiotropy. Pleiotropy means one gene control multiple phenotypes. One gene is related to several phenotypes. And such genes are called pleiotropic genes. Here, several genes, gene 1, gene 2, gene 3, control the same character. Gene 1, gene 2, gene 3 is related to one character. That means one character is controlled by several genes, then it is called polygenic inheritance. Polygenic inheritance. I think you understand the difference between pleiotropy and polygenic inheritance. Here, several genes control one character. Here, one gene controls several characters. This is the main difference between pleiotropy and polygenic inheritance. And polygenic inheritance can be measured in metric measurements like size, weight, strength, etc. Size, weight, strength, etc. And these polygenes, polygenic traits or characters are sensitive to environmental changes. Another important point. Polygenic traits are sensitive to environmental changes. So environment may influence the polygenic traits. As they influence as they are influenced by environment, the transmission of polygenic traits is generally low. Transmission of polygenic inheritance is generally low because it is easily influenced by environment. So great amount of environmental influence is there, automatically the transmission is comparatively less. Okay, right. And unlike oligogenic inheritance, where they show discontinuous variations, this particular polygenic inheritance causes continuous variations. Continuous variations rather than discontinuous variations. Polygenic inheritance causes continuous variations rather than discontinuous variations, right? And the best examples, in case of Mendelian inheritance, we have seen two extremities, for example, tall plants and dwarf plants. But in nature, between these two heights, there are several heights in between that. That means these two are controlled by several genes. For example, take human height between longest and the shortest. There are various types, and these are quantitative characters, and these are controlled by several genes. And remember, each gene contributes an amount of phenotype. Each gene contributes. Several genes control one character. That character is controlled by all the genes. Each gene controls that particular character. But the contribution of each gene is difficult to detect. The contribution of each gene is difficult to detect, but it is a cumulative effect of all the genes to express that particular character. It is the cumulative effect of all the genes that control that one, that character. But each one is very difficult. What is the contribution of each gene to detect is a difficult one. The example for polygenic inheritance, example for polygenic inheritance is kernel color in wheat. Kernel color in wheat. Similarly, human height, there are various types of heights are present between the tallest and the shortest. That is also best example for quantitative inheritance. And similarly, human skin color, like that, there are several characters are there which are controlled by many genes. Okay, so I am going to explain the polygenic inheritance by using human skin color an example. Human skin color. Is one of the best example for polygenic inheritance. This skin color is controlled by a melanin pigment. Melanin pigment is responsible for human skin color. More is the melanin pigment, darker is the skin color, and less is the pigment, lighter is the color, like that. And this human skin color is controlled by three pairs of genes present on different loci. Three pairs of genes present on different loci. Three pairs of genes means six genes, right? They control human skin color. Now, when a human being having very dark skin color married a very light skin color containing person, very light. In the F1, all mulattoes are produced. Mulattoes means intermediate skin color. For example, the genotypes here is capital A, capital A, capital B, capital B, capital C, capital C. Here, small a, small a, small b, small b, small c, right? When all the dominant genes, it give very dark color. And all are recessive, it produces very light color. That means these dominant genes produces fixed amount of melanin. Each dominant gene produces a fixed amount of melanin. That is responsible for the skin color. And when this person, having this skin color containing person, married with this skin color containing person in the F1, all our mulattoes are produced. So therefore the genotype is capital A, small a, capital B, small b, capital C, small c. Here all dominant genes gives very dark skin color. Here all recessive genes gives very light skin color. And here 50% dominant and 50% recessive genes, it produces intermediate skin color. In the F2, between these two skin colors, in between these two extremities, you can find different shades of skin colors. In the ratio, the phenotypes are obtained in the ratio of 1:6:15:20:6:10:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20:20: 15:6:1. See, number of phenotypes, number of phenotypes obtained is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 phenotypes are obtained in the ratio of 1:6:15:20:15:6:1. Right? This is the F2. So F2 are obtained in this ratio. Here, this is very dark and this is very light. Between these two, there are various shades are produced. Here it is dark, D for dark, and here fairly dark. Here intermediate, and here fairly light. Here light and very light. I repeat, there are different shades of skin colors appear in F2. With this ratio, the F2 phenotypic ratio is of polygenic inheritance. F2 phenotypic ratio of polygenic inheritance is 1:6:15:20:15:6:1. So there are totally 7 types of phenotypes are obtained. The phenotypes of these 7 types are, see, from here to here, the number of dominant genes decreases. Therefore, the color changes gradually. The dark color decreases and become light. So, all dominant genes are present like this, very dark. One recessive remaining dominant genes. They are different types, right? Dark. Here, two recessive genes remaining are dominant. Here, 50% dominant, 50% recessive. Here, only two dominant genes, remaining recessive genes. Here, only one dominant gene, remaining genes are recessive. Here, all are recessive genes. So, very dark. Darkest skin color is produced if all the genes are dominant. And very light skin color is produced if all the alleles of all the genes are recessive. I will tell you a simple formula to determine the number of phenotypes formed. In case of polygenic inheritance, the number of phenotypes formed is equal to 2n plus 1.
number of phenotypes formed is equal to 2n plus 1, where n is equal to number of different genes. For example, here capital B, capital C, capital C. Okay. How many types of different genes? These are 3 types. Therefore, n is equal to 3. Therefore, 2n is equal to 2n plus 1. That is equal to 2 into 3 plus 1. That is equal to 6 plus 1. That is 7. Okay. Like that. 7 are up here. This is very simple formula to know the number of types of phenotypes obtained. In case of polygenic inheritance, the number of phenotypes formed is equal to 2n plus 1. Where n is the number of different genes. For example, if the genotype for polygenic inheritance is capital A, capital B, capital C. That means 3 different genes are present. N is equal to 3. Totally, we will get 7 types of phenotypes, as in this case. So this is the best example for human skin color. Similarly, in case of kernel color, in wheat, when this character is controlled by 2 pairs of alleles, like capital A, capital B, that means 2 pairs of genes, capital A, capital B, small a, small b. It produces capital A, small a, capital B. It's not dihybrid cross, it is polygenic inheritance. And in the F2, they are obtained in the ratio of, this is F1. In the F2, the phenotypes are obtained in the ratio of 1:4:6:4:1. So this is also a polygenic ratio if 2 pairs of genes are involved. If 2 pairs of genes are involved, the number of types of phenotypes, is equal to 5 types. See this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If a polygenic character is controlled by 2 pairs of genes in F2, the ratio is obtained like this, that is 1:4:6:4:1. Similarly, if it is controlled by 3 pairs of genes, F2 phenotypic ratio is 1:6:15:20:15:16:1. That means these 2 ratios are polygenic inheritance ratios, F2 phenotypes. So this is about polygenic inheritance. The next one, probability. Next one is probability. What is meant by probability? The likelihood of occurrence of a particular event is called as the likelihood or chance of occurrence of a particular event is called probability. That means probability is equal to the number of times that a particular event occurs by total number of possible outcomes. total number of possible outcomes. The number of times that a particular event occurs by total number of the possible outcomes. Generally, probability is represented by a symbol. Probability is represented by a symbol called P. Probability can be represented by a symbol called P. That and the range of probability. Range of probability is 0 to 1. Here, certainly an event does not occur. An event does not occur. The event doesn't happen. Is 0. Here, 100% certainly an event occurs. 100% certainly an event occurs is 1 and 0 does not occur. So, probability ranges between 0 to 1. That means P is equal to 0. Certainly, event does not occur. P is equal to 1. Certainly, event occurs. Okay. What is the use of probability in genetics? Yes. Probability is useful to predict a particular trait of an organism and also inheritance pattern and also helps in diseases in the family lines. Probability is useful to predict the particular type of trait in an organism and also the diseases in the family lines in order to predict the disease in the family history. We can predict by knowing the probability. Right. Then, probability loss. Probability loss. There are mainly two laws of probability. One is addition law. Second one is addition law. Second one is multiplication law. Addition law, multiplication law. Addition law also called sum rule. This is also called product rule. Addition law, multiplication law. Okay. There are two probability laws. One is addition law, second one is multiplication law. Discuss one by one. First one, addition law or sum rule. Addition law or sum rule. What is addition law? One of the several mutually exclusive events will occur is the sum of the probabilities of individual events. I repeat, one of the several mutually exclusive events will occur is the sum of the probabilities of individual events. This is called addition law. I will explain with example. For example, capital A, small a, capital A, small a. when these are crossed, what is the probability of dominant phenotype? What is the probability of dominant phenotype? Let us see. How can you predict the dominant phenotype from these two individuals? There are three events. There are three events occur. In any fertilization event, only one occur out of the three. The three possible outcomes are, let us see. One gamete having this allele meets with the other gamete of other parent having this one. So, capital A containing gamete of male meets with capital A of female. This is one option. Therefore, capital A gives dominant phenotype. The second option is capital A allele containing gamete of male meets with small a containing allele of female. There is a possibility of dominant phenotype. And small a containing gamete of male meets with capital A containing allele of female, like this. There are three individual events. So that means in any fertilization, one of these three events in any fertilization event, in any fertilization event, only one of these three will occur. Okay. Therefore, in this case, we can apply some rule. You know what is the probability of each of these events? 1/4. That means capital A, 1/4. Plus capital A, 1/4. Capital A, 1/4. If you add these three individual probabilities, you will get 3/4. So the probability of the dominant phenotypes when from these individuals is 3/4. The probability of these two is 3/4. Okay. So from this Punnett square, we can easily understood this one also. Okay. See, capital A, small a, these are the gametes of male. Think that these are the gametes of female. So it has 1/4 chance to combine this one. It has 1/4 chance to combine this one. It has also 1/4 chance to combine this one. But this is not the dominant phenotype. Therefore, so in this case, you can see it has 1/4 chance to combine this one, 1/4. It has 1/4 again, 1/4. And it can with 1/4, therefore, we will get 3/4. So the possibility of dominant phenotypes, you're talking about phenotypes, not the genotypes. Phenotypes is like this, that is 3/4. So this is the simple explanation for addition law. Then next one is product or multiplication law. Multiplication law. What is multiplication law? Multiplication law means that probability of two or more events occur together can be calculated by multiplying the probabilities of individual events. The probability of two or more events occur together is calculated by multiplying the probabilities of individual events. is called product rule or multiplication law. Similarly, we will see one example. When cross is occurs between these two, what is the possibility of genotype small a in the next generation? From this cross, what is the possibility of genotype small a? What is the possibility of this one? Let us see. You know, out of small a, capital A, each parent contribution is 1/2. This parent has 25%, that is 50%, and it also has 50%. Therefore, if you apply the multiplication rule, 1/2 × 1/2, that is equal to 1/4. So in the next generation, the possibility of this genotype is 1/4. Similarly, if you look at the Punnett square also, you can easily find here like this, that is capital A, small a, capital A, small a, and this is capital A, capital A, capital A, small a, capital A, small a, and small a, small a. That means one by two chance of one parent combined with this one, another parent, you will get 1/2 × 1/2, that is equal to 1/4. So the possibility of outcome of this genotype is 1/4. So like that, you can apply this multiplication rule and the addition rules, right? Based on these probabilities, we can calculate the phenotypes and genotypes of monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross. For example, in case of heterozygous genotype, that is capital Y small y, what is the probability of capital T? 1/2 capital T. What is the probability of small t? 1/2. Therefore, if you apply the this one, capital A plus small a whole square is equal to capital A plus 2 capital A small a plus small a small a. Similarly, if you apply this one, you will get capital T plus small t whole square, that is equal to 1/4 capital A plus 1/2 capital A small a plus 1/4 small a small a. Therefore, you will get the ratio of F2 in 1:2 to 1 ratio. Okay, like this you can calculate. Similarly, now we are going to discuss about the probabilities of phenotypes and genotypes in dihybrid cross. Calculation of probability of phenotypes in dihybrid cross. In dihybrid cross, probability of F2 phenotypes. Dihybrid cross, F2 phenotypes. So in dihybrid cross, each character is controlled by one gene. Therefore, two genes are involved. So that two genes, when you multiply, you will get the probabilities here. Let us see. First one, gene 1, gene 2, and probability of F2 phenotypes. Let us see. So what are the phenotypes which control over gene 1? For example, yellow, round. You know, yellow, round, what is the probability? Yellow. If you see this one, you will get capital Y, small y. Yellow, green. So what is the probability? 3/4. Similarly, this is also dominant character. You will get 3/4. Therefore, 3/4 × 3/4, 9/16. yellow round are obtained. Exactly, in dihybrid cross, 9 out of 16 individuals are yellow round individuals. Like that. So if you calculate the probability of phenotypes. Similarly, what is the probability of yellow wrinkled? So as usual, yellow probability is 3/4. Wrinkled probability, wrinkled means, so in the next cross, in another cross, here the recessive character. Therefore, 1/4. 3/4 into 1/4, you will get 3/16 yellow wrinkled. You can calculate like this. And third one is green. What is the probability of green? Just 1/4. Then, what is the probability of round? As usual, 3/4, because it is a dominant character. 1/4 into 3/4, 3/16. That is green round. They are green round. Similarly, the fourth one is 1/4 green. And similarly, 1/4 wrinkled. That is equal to 1/16. Green, wrinkled. Green, wrinkled. Green, this is green wrinkled. Okay. Therefore, finally, you will get 1, 2, 3, 4 types of phenotypes in the ratio of F to phenotypic ratio, that is 9:3:1. Okay, the hybrid cross. So, like this, we can calculate the probability of the phenotypes. Whatever the phenotypes are given from their monohybrid crosses, we can calculate the dihybrid genotypes, phenotypes. Now, we will see the genotypes. So, I think you understand. This is dihybrid cross. These are individual monohybrid cross probabilities. So, by multiplying this, you will get this one. And next one is dihybrid cross F2 genotypes, probability of F2 genotypes. How can you calculate? By using probability. So here also, dihybrid cross is controlled by two genes, right? Gene 2 and probability of genotypes. If you know the genotypes, automatically you will get the phenotypes. Okay, phenotypes. See, one, what is the probability of capital Y? So very easy in case of this one. For example, capital Y, capital Y, capital Y, small Y. So probability of Y, 3/4, sorry, 1/4, 2/4, 2/4, 1/4. From this, 1/4 into gene 2 means round. Similar to capital R, capital R, capital R, smaller. So here also, 1/4 capital R. So that also I will draw here. Capital R, capital R, capital R, smaller. 1/4, 2/4, 2/4, 1/4. Now you can calculate here. You will get 1/4 into 1/4. 1/16. Capital Y, capital Y, capital R. Okay, and if you know the genotype, these are dominant, therefore the phenotype is yellow round. Okay, then second one, 1/4. So as usual, here what is the probability of capital R small R? 2 by 4. Okay, those two, 2 by 4. Now you will get 1 by 4 into 2 by 4, 2 by 16. 2 by 16. That is capital Y, capital Y, capital R, small r. Same yellow round phenotype. Yellow round because the dominant gene expressed in both homozygous and heterozygous conditions. The next one, 1 by 4, capital Y, small y, into what is the probability of small r, 1 by 4. That is equal to 1 by 16. That is capital Y, small r, the phenotypes are yellow, wrinkled. Yellow wrinkled. Then next one. What is the probability of capital Y small y? 2 by 4. Into 1 by 4 capital R, capital R. Already you know that. Therefore, 2 by 4 into 1 by 4. 2 by 16 capital Y small y, capital R, capital R. This is yellow round. Yellow round. Then next one, fifth one. 2 by 4 capital Y small y into 2 by 4 capital R small r. 2 by 4 into 2 by 4. 4 by 16. Capital Y small y, capital R small r. Same yellow round as that of the previous one. Then next one, 2 by 4 capital Y small y into what is the small r probability? 1 by 4. That is equal to 2 by 16. 2 by 4 into 1 by 4. The genotypes are capital Y, small r, and these are yellow wrinkled. Yellow wrinkled. Right? Then next one is seventh one. 2 by 4. What is the probability? 1 by 4. Into 1 by 4 capital R, that is 1 by 16 small y capital R, this is green round, green round. Then next one, 1 by 4 small y into 2 by 4 capital R small r. Therefore, 1 by 4 into 2 by 4, 2 by 16, 2 by 16, that form small y, capital R, small r. These are also green round. And lastly, 1 by 4 small y into 1 by 4 small r, that form 1 by 16, small y, small r, small r. Gives green. Okay. Therefore, 9 types of genotypes are obtained in the ratio of 1:2, 2:2, 4:2, 1:2, 2:2, 1:2, 2:1. So this is F2 genotypic ratio. F2 genotypic ratio. So these are the only 4 types of phenotypes. But genotypes are 9 types are given like this. So whatever may be the genotype is given, we can calculate its probability. For example, without looking at this, I am giving one. Capital Y, small r. How many individuals having this type of genotype is produced in the F2 in case of dihybrid cross? The question is asked like that.
Like that.
So how can you determine the probability of this genotype?
So capital Y, small y, probability out of 4, 2 types, 2 by 4, okay? Similarly, what is the probability of small r out of 4, 1 by 4? 1 by 4, that is equal to 2 by 16. Out of 16 individuals in dihybrid cross, this type of genotype containing individuals are 2. Is it correct or not? Let us check. Capital Y, small y, see, capital Y, small y, capital Y, small y, see this small r, see this one, capital Y, small r, 2 by 16, this is right, capital Y, small r, how many are produced? 2 by 16, like that, we can calculate whatever the genotype is given. For example, this genotype is given, Y, R. If you don't know the ratio or the Punnett square, difficult. Immediately, what will you do? This is one monohybrid cross, this is another monohybrid cross. In monohybrid cross, how many types of Y are obtained? 2 by 4. Yeah, similarly capital R smaller, 2 by 4. Therefore, 2 by 4 into 2 by 4. Look at that. 2 by 4 into 2 by 4. 4 by 16 are obtained. That means out of the 16 genotypes obtained, this type of genotypes are produced 4. See here, capital Y small y, capital R smaller. How many are obtained with this type? 4. So out of 16, 4 individuals are having this type of genotype. Simply by looking, by knowing the genotype, we can calculate its probability. So that is about probability. So that's all. Thank you.